In this video, we will take the definite integral of hyperbolic functions. So the first example will be the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the 4x minus e to the negative 4x divided by 2 dx. So notice immediately that you can split this into two integrals. You can take out the half one, first of all, right? So from 0 to 1, e to the 4x minus e to the negative 4x, okay, dx. And if you want to split this into two integrals, you can, but you really don't need to do that. Well, actually, yeah, it's better to do it because you will have a u substitution. Okay, so we're going to split it in two. So we're going to have e4x dx minus 1 half from 0 to 1 of e negative 4x dx. Okay, so in this case, you're going to use the u substitution. U is equal to 4x. The du is equal to 4 dx. Okay, so dx will be equal to du over 4. In this case, let us use the v substitution so as to not to confuse you, because the first integral had a u. So v is equal to negative 4x, dv is equal to negative 4 dx. So the dx is equal to negative dv over 4. Okay, so now we can write this as 1 half times, well, actually, we also have to change the variables, right? So u as a function of x, when x is equal to 0, u is equal to 4 times 0, which is 0, right? 4x, 4 times 0. U as a function of x is equal to 1. We will have 4 times 1, which is 4. In this case, v as a function of x, when x is equal to 0, we will have 0. And v as a function of x, when x is equal to 1, we will have negative 4. Okay? And don't be afraid that there is a minus sign. We're going to work through that. Okay? So first we're going to have 1 half. Okay? And from 0 to 4 for the first integral, because now we're dealing with the u. So we're going to keep the e to the 4x, and let's substitute the dx part. So that's going to be the du over 4, okay? And then the second integral is going to be minus 1 half from 0 to negative 4. Don't worry about the fact that the upper limit is less. We're going to talk about it. So from 0 to negative 4, so let's write e to the negative 4x, and then let's write the dx in terms of dv. That's going to be minus dv. So remember that this is multiplied, minus dv over 4. Okay, so let's see what that gives us. Actually, I should write here e to the u, because, yeah, so we're going to write e to the u here. Let me erase this part as well. And this is going to be v, okay? So e to the u here, and here is going to be e to the v, right? Because u is equal to 4x, v is equal to negative 4x, okay? So now let's see what's going to happen. So as you can see, 1 half is multiplying also 1 fourth, right? So as a result, we have 1 eighth outside the first integral from 0 to 4, e to the u du. And then for the second integral, notice that your upper limit is less than the lower limit. And in order to make it true, in order to switch it, in order to have minus 4 to be the lower limit and the upper limit 0, you will need to, you can basically negate the integral, right? So you will have plus 1 half from negative 4 to 0. Also we have to take care of the minus sign, right? So yeah, it gets a little bit complicated. So let's take care of that. I'm gonna just take care of the signs for you so that you can see what's going on in here. So we'll write minus 1/2, right? Because remember, we negated when we put the upper limit as the lower limit and the zero on top. So we negated that. But also we have a third minus in there for the dv minus 4. Right, so we can write negative 1/4 in here outside the integral. So negative 4 is the lower limit now. The upper limit is 0. So we have ev dv. There we go. Now it's easier. So now we're going to have, let's integrate the first part. We're going to get 1/8 e to the u integrated from 0 to 4. And then let's see how many minuses we have. We have a plus 1/2. Well, actually 1/8, the resulting fraction, but then the minuses, three minuses give you a minus, right? So it's going to be minus 1/8 integrated, well, wait a second, e to the v integrated from negative 4 to 0. So let's see what that crazy gives us. So 1/8 e to the 4 minus e to the 0, right? E to the 0 is 1, so we can just write 1, then minus 1/8 integrating 1, right, because e to the v, when v is equal to 0, e to the 0 is 1, minus, right, subtracting, using the fundamental theorem of calculus, remember there's a subtraction, and there's also a minus 4 there, so there will be e to the negative 4, right, e to the negative 4, there we go. So let's see what we get. We get 1/8 e to the 4 minus 1/8 minus 1/8 plus 1/8 e to the negative 4. Okay, so now as a side note, this looks really interesting, right? What we got as a result. So let's first take care of this negative 1/8 being written twice. So that means that we can add these two and we'll get negative 1/4, right? So negative 1/4, and look at something really cool here. We will have plus 1/8, and we can combine 1/8 for e to the 4 and e to the negative 4. So it's going to be e to the 4 plus e to the negative 4. And now, why am I going to write a side note? Note that cosh of x is equal to e to the x plus e to the negative x over 2, right? So basically, what's going to happen is that you can write this guy as cosh of 4, okay? So you can split this up as negative 1/4 plus 1/4 cosh of 4, right? Because 1/4 makes sure that 1/2 is being inside this parentheses, right? So imagine that we use the formula here, we're going to divide this thing, e to the 4 plus e to the negative 4 by 2, then this fraction becomes 1/4 as a result. That's why I have a 1/4, and this guy inside the parentheses, e to the 4 plus e to the negative 4 divided by 2, becomes cosh of 2, right? Because x in this case is equal to, cosh of 4, because x in this case is equal to 4, right? And we divide it by 2. Okay, so this is your antiderivative. Definite integral value in this case, okay? So I hope you found this video useful. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video.